They will be discussing, talking about it. Of course, we'll be collecting the e-waste, and we would like that from 15th of January to 31st of January, if we can, you know, collect from the various schools.
Sure.
And at the same time, my dear beloved students and teachers, I believe the exams are there. I believe the holidays are there. We'll extend the deadline. So it's not that we have finished the 31st of January, and 2 weeks means 2 weeks. We'll have the first activities designed for 3 weeks. It's okay. So another minute to go. And Charu, why don't you please share the screen? So good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's such a wonderful day because one, we are starting a new project, that's RISA for e-waste. And second, we have a fabulous expert today who's going to talk to all of us and let us know what this e-waste is all about, the challenges that he has been doing all these days. So this is an international project where we have children and teenagers joining from all around the globe. Yes, please, Charu.
This class will be all there.
Our partners are S. P. Chopal, Karo Sambhav, Thrashen, Smart Sustain, and PR Zero Waste. I'm so delighted. We at Kamala Nehru Public School has initiated this project. And the best part is we have a large team, one team of wonderful educators and students. Very, very energetic students. Thank you so much. Very, very great change agents, the teachers. Yes, please.
Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, darling. And then these are the SDGs we are going to work when we talk about RISA for e-waste. These are the SDG 3, good health and well-being, 6, clean water and sanitation, 14, life below water, decent work and economic growth, sustainable cities and communities, goal number 11, 12, responsible consumption and production, 16, peace, justice, and institutions are related. And as we go along in this journey of RISA for e-waste, we'll be connecting our activities with these goals. And now we have Mr. Pranshu Missinger. He is the founder of Karo Sambhav, which designs and implements transformative circular and EPR solutions by collaborating with.
Madam Dilo, your voice is not audible.
Ma'am, we can't hear you.
Madam, we can't hear you.
Must be joining in a short while, sir. We can wait. This is our new normal, everybody. So have patience. Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, everybody. We can please mute yourself. Mom is going to join, then we'll start.
Hello.
Okay, so you can mute yourself, everybody. Just wait.
Mute.
We are just waiting. We are just waiting, children. We are just waiting. You can mute yourself. Just wait a few more seconds, minutes.
Mom, what is the timing, Mom?
We are going to start. It is 5:35 right now, Indian Standard Time. And yes, Ma'am is here. You can see Charu Ma'am is here. Good evening, Ma'am.
Hello, Ma'am.
All lovely faces. They all are waiting for the session to start.
Can you not hear me, please?
You've got 195 participants all over the world. We will start. We are just waiting. There is some network issue, maybe. Don't worry, children. We are waiting. It happens, isn't it, during online sessions as well? Sometimes it happens or not? Yes? So we are just.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening. Yes. Wonderful children, they all are waiting patiently. This is our first meeting for Rise Up, for e-waste. So we are going to learn something new today. Yay! I can see Ishan is excited.
Yes, ma'am, excited.
Hello. I believe I'm not heard, but I'm muted myself.
You're now audible, ma'am.
So can you hear me now, please?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Paramjit, ma'am, you're audible now.
I had to change the setting. I'm so, so sorry. I've taken good 5, 7, 8 minutes. Charu, can we share the screen again, please? I am extremely sorry. I had to change the setting. I don't know what happened. Technology, we are all yours.
Yes, yes, ma'am. And kids are, these are, no, they have learned now. They were quietly waiting, ma'am. So,
okay. So, could you hear the first few slides or not even that?
Yes, we could.
Ma'am, no, ma'am. No, ma'am.
My God. Show the most important slide when I wanted to introduce yourself. I got lost somewhere in this world.
No worries. I am happy to take over when you are convenient. I am happy to start.
Ma'am, voice is not coming properly.
So is it all right? Is it okay now?
No, yes.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
It is, dear. You can mute yourself, children. It will be audible. Don't worry. Just mute yourself.
I'm not audible, ma'am.
You can
now
mute yourself.
Am I audible? Okay. Yes. Okay. Anshu, I think you start. Let me set my system. Please. Sure. Over to Pranshu. Over to Pranshu.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, madam. And I am delighted to meet all of you children here, and really, really delighted to be a part of this great effort, Rise Up for E-Waste. It's really fortunate to do it with Kamala Nehru School, who has played a leading role in a lot of social initiatives, not just in India, but also has risen to occasions and showed international schools the way of how to do it. So let's today talk about e-waste. And any student, if you want to stop me and want to understand if some things are not clear, please feel free to interrupt. So I will try to share what is e-waste, why is it important for us to act upon it, and what can we, as you know, even in this very young age, do something about it. Because sometimes we believe that no, e-waste is something, or waste is something that I am not concerned about. This is something that my parents would, this is something to do with my parents. But we will, as we go through the slides, we will see that all of us have our own unique ways of influencing things. And we can all bring in a massive, massive change if we are to believe that the change is possible. And if you all recall, you know, for the last 2 years, I know it has been a very painful 2 years, especially for students. When I look at my own daughter, she has missed going to schools like anything. So, but if you see, you know, while there was so much negative things about what happened, there was at least one positive thing, that our skies became clear. So something that we had not anticipated, something that we had not imagined, but at least what we learned was even skies in Delhi could be clear. So what I'm going to share may sound like a very big problem, but if we all work cohesively, if we find a way of addressing it, it is possible to tackle this very large problem of electronic waste. So let us first understand what essentially is e-waste. What is the problem of e-waste? And why is it suddenly a big issue? Yes.
I'm not able to mute myself. Can you mute me?
Can someone please help? Okay, so let me start with what is electronic waste.
Sir, voice is not coming properly.
Okay, I'll try to speak a bit louder.
Yes,
sir. So e-waste, you know, if you look all around you, actually all the gadgets that you see, all of you have access to a mobile phone, you would have television sets, washing machines, refrigerators in your homes. So all the things that work on electricity, once they become dead, you know, like sometimes your mobile, at some time your mobile phone will not work. Sometimes your laptop will die. At other times your bulbs will stop working. So once any electrical or electronic product has stopped working and it has reached a time when it cannot be utilized anymore, it becomes what is called e-waste. So e-waste can come from, example, from IT and telecommunication equipment. Like all of you are now probably using your laptops or a tablet for talking to us. Or it could be coming from consumer side. So your refrigerators.
Sir, not audible.
So like refrigerators, washing machines, televisions. So all these things can contribute to electronic waste. So, I mean, if you look around yourself, you will see there are so many gadgets, you know, that we all use, but we generally don't think what will happen to them once they are dead. So e-waste is something which is becoming a very, very important and a very challenging problem for all of us, because it is, first of all, in huge quantities, and the products are dying faster. Earlier, we used to, for example, use mobile phone for at least 5 years. Nowadays, we only use mobile phone for 2 years. So on a general basis, you know, the laptops, for example, will die in 5 years. Your television sets will die in 12 years. So there are different lifespans of each and every product. And at some point in time, these products will die. So how do we take care of these products when they are dead is a big, big challenge, and we need to figure out how do we work on this together. So let me give you a good idea of, you know, all of you know, I believe, Eiffel Tower in Paris. So if we compare the waste, you know, how much electronic waste we are generating every year.
It is difficult for everyone to join the meeting, sir.
Okay. So, if we were to look at how much electronic waste do we produce every year, and we compare it to the Eiffel Towers, we are talking of almost 4,500 Eiffel Towers equivalent of waste. So, I hope you can imagine how much quantity of electronic waste we are generating each year. And this is only increasing. Every year, this increases by another 10, 20 lakh tons. So it's a very, very big waste and the fastest growing waste stream of the world. Now think about yourself or your parents. Don't they change mobile phones very often? Like every 2 years, they would be changing their mobile phones. Now what happens when we change products, or if the products die so fast? We start putting a lot of pressure on our natural resources. So when you think of a mobile phone, it has certain plastics, it has copper, it has steel, it has iron, it has very small amount of gold, very small amount of palladium. But there are a whole lot of materials that are required to produce an electronic device like a mobile phone. Now, once these products are dead, what we can do is extract these materials back from the products. So,
sir, what is electronic waste, sir?
So as I said, I repeat, electronic waste is waste which is coming out of your electronic equipments once they die. So things like television sets, at some time it will stop working.
Sir, we can't use it again.
Is it a problem for everyone? Madam Dillo, can you hear me?
No, Pranshu, you are audible.
Please,
I think.
Pranshu, you are very clear.
Sir, your voice is not coming properly.
Maybe the issue
with the internet connection.
Maybe the issue is slow internet at their end.
Yes.
No, ma'am, just turn up the. What is my mood doing?
Sure, I will continue. So,
yes.
Yeah. So electrical and electronic waste is anything that you know, any equipment which works on electricity, it will die at some point in time. Think of toaster, oven, sandwich makers, you know, hairdressers, all these things at some point in time, they stop functioning. So once they stop functioning, that product becomes what is called e-waste. And e-waste, because a lot of gadgets are being introduced in our life on a daily basis, the amount of e-waste which is being generated is increasing multiple fold.
Sir, Ishan?
Yes?
Sir, after they become dead, if they are not recycled, so what are the steps we can do? It will pollute the environment, so what we can do?
Yes, Ishan, I will come and answer your question in the next few minutes. Okay, sir. Thank you for asking. So if we look, who is producing,
sir,
the largest?
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, my friends, many of them cannot join the meeting, sir. Only 200 attendees can join, sir.
Yeah, I understand. It's a problem with Microsoft Teams that only 200 people can join.
Sir.
This is WebEx, not Microsoft Teams, sir.
This is WebEx?
Yes, sir. It is WebEx.
Yeah, so hopefully here they should be able to join.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, instead of throwing this e-waste, we can give it to our relatives or friends, or we can pass it to any manufacturer company, isn't it, sir?
Yes. So let me talk about it. So once, for example, what do we do regularly? When our product is not being utilized by us, we generally sell it back. We either sell it to a repair shop or we give it to a friend, to some family member, to some maid, but we give it away. But still, you know, it can be used for maybe another few years. At some point in time, the product will die. So when we start classifying a product as e-waste, once it is fully dead, which means it cannot be utilized anymore. After that, once this waste is generated, it needs to be recycled. So I will come to recycling part of e-waste, but let's look at what is the global trend. How much e-waste are we generating across the world? So China today is the biggest producer of electronic waste. They produce over 10 million tons of electronic waste, followed by United States of America at 6.9 million tons, and then India. And India is very fast catching up this, because today electronics are getting into every house. So the more we utilize, the more electronic waste will be there in the future. Yeah. So if we look in India, what are the states which are contributing to the biggest generation of electronic waste? Maharashtra generates the highest amount, followed by Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, UP, West Bengal, and then Delhi. So we are all starting to produce very, very large quantities of electronic waste. Now let's understand why is
electronic waste?
Yes. E-waste is both electrical and electronic, not just electronic. So even your fans, light bulbs, even they are classified as e-waste.
So a stethoscope is also considered in electronic devices.
So it is covering, Ishan, it covers both electrical and electronic, both types of waste. Okay. So okay, if you look at what is the problem with this waste, why should we be concerned about it? The first is, it is starting to become very large quantum. So India is now become the third largest producer of waste. Over 95% of the e-waste is not handled properly. So what happens is, you know, for example, wires of electronic waste, they are...
Sir?
Yeah. Someone is...
Sir, stopping future my communication we will have the screen. Water issue, sir.
Yeah, sorry?
Chatji, someone is sharing.
Yeah, no, I put it back. So what is happening? So if we don't recycle e-waste properly, what happens is we generally give our e-waste to a kabadiwala. So some kabadiwala will come. Now what kabadiwala does is, he will try to extract as many materials from the e-waste. So what will they do? For wires, they will just burn the wires. Now what happens when you burn the wires? There is a lot of air pollution which will happen. Dioxins, furans will be generated when you burn all the wires to take out copper. Or if they are to handle printers, a lot of ink is, you know, printer has some ink which is hazardous, that is left in the open ground. Or if we are trying to extract certain precious materials, there are cyanide based acid baths which are utilized, so which end up polluting the earth. Now what happens when we release these toxic materials from electronic waste? If we are not recycling them properly, they will ultimately get into our soil and the groundwater and ultimately reach to our own bodies by entering the food chain. So, and there are various impacts electronic waste on human health. So they can lead to lung cancer, kidney failure, many other types of very, very disastrous diseases which can be caused.
Sir, someone is calling you.
Sir? Sir?
Yeah.
What? How can we save e-waste?
I am coming to it, Vita. Just let me complete this part and I'll explain how do we solve the problem.
Okay, sir.
What can we do as students? So another important impact from e-waste is it can also lead to groundwater pollution, soil acidification. And if we start recycling it, what is the biggest benefit of e-waste recycling? It is that we will not need to mine fresh material. Now think of your laptop, you know, in front, you are right now in front of a laptop. This laptop has some amount of plastics, it has glass, it has tin, it has copper. Now, where are these materials coming from? They come from mining. Now, mining has significant environmental impacts. If we do not mine, if we are able to take out the same materials from e-waste, then we will not need to mine the forests. We will not need to cut down the forest for mining purposes. So there is a very, very positive impact if we start recycling our electronic waste. Now, how do we move from Abhi? So what do we do tomorrow? Tell me, a few students, if you can tell me, what happens to e-waste at your home? What do you do?
Can I tell?
Yes.
Sir, can Ishan tell? Sir, can Ishan?
No, Ishan, let someone else share.
Pranjal?
Yes. Yeah, Pranjal.
Okay, so what do we do with the electronic waste is that we have an NGO in our locality, so we just contribute there and, you know, they recycle it.
Have you ever asked what do they do when they say recycling? Have you tried to understand recycling?
Yeah, actually no, but because, you know, my family member goes there and I never asked it. But when I am this collecting this information about e-waste, so I got to know many things that how can we recycle it.
Very good. So my thing, as children, as 21st century learners, you should always ask these questions that, okay, what is recycling? If someone is telling you, you know, we are taking it for recycling, your next question should be, what will you take out of this product? How will you recycle? So that you can start understanding that is recycling really happening, and is it the best way of recycling? Can there be better ways? Because you may be able to come up eventually with better ways of recycling.
Sir, can I tell what happens to his house on by e-waste?
Yeah, please.
Sir, we sell it on second hand.
And what is meant by these two?
Sure. So a lot of people sell their working products as second hand goods, but there will still be some things which cannot be sold as second hand. So in most cases, what we do is we just hand it to a kabadiwala along with newspapers, you know, other things that we sell to him. So, and that is wrong practice. That is something that we should not do. We should ask.
So can I tell why we should not do
in
that?
In my house, yes. What happened? Can Shan tell with e-waste?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So usually when the electronic device stops working, we throw it up. But as we discussed in our last, as we discussed, I searched it in the internet. So it was some tips that you can give it to the manufacturing company or some people who can prepare it best as he could. So now I have started electronic device distributing to them. You can make it best of it.
Yes. So what you can do, let me share about electronic waste that are there in the country. So you can always find the brand on the device. So for example, if it's a dead mobile phone, you can see which brand. It could be an Apple, it could be Nokia, it could be Samsung, it could be Xiaomi. So you can always call the brand and ask them to collect it. Or you can ask, where do I dispose this? Because it is their responsibility to today provide a solution to people like me and you. So for any company that is today putting an electronic product on the market, they are supposed to create collection points. I come from an organization, Karusanta. We have 50 collection points across the country. So either you can come and drop your waste at these collection points from where they will go for recycling, or you can go to the website of the company who has sold this product, and you can ask there and you can check there where and how do you dispose your product. So every company has a responsibility to create a solution for recycling. So know this is your right. It is important that you know this point. Similarly, if I were to talk about schools, under the rules that we have, each and every school is supposed to be a bulk consumer. So every school also needs to dispose their e-waste responsibly and submit their annual returns to State Pollution Control Board. So if you are a school, ensure that you have a policy on how you will dispose your electronic waste, you are maintaining those records, and then submitting these records to State Pollution Control Board. This is a legal responsibility of the school or any institution which has more than 20 people working or 20 people sitting there. So one of the biggest things is, so for example, if you want to recycle with Karo Sambhav, you can go to our website. There are 50 plus collection points mentioned. So you can go to the collection point in those cities and drop, or you can call us and you can understand how do we support collection and recycling of this waste. Now, under this campaign, I believe you all will be collecting waste at your own schools. So once you have collected this waste, you can reach out to us and we will help you dispose it. What are the ways? You know, here I've tried to list down very simple way that once you know that there is a product which needs to be recycled, look out at the website of that brand, see where are their drop-off points, visit that point, drop off your e-waste there. But before you drop off, make sure that you remove all your personal data, because today on mobile phones, we have a lot of data which is stored. So it is very important that we all store this data and manage it responsibly. And then you can, if you want, you can also invite organizations like ours to come and do a campaign at your residential colonies or in your own organization. Can someone stop sharing their screen? My screen is getting unshared again and again. So someone is trying to just share their screen again and again. Yeah, what are the things that you should not do? So do not try to recycle the product at your own home. Now, some of these products may contain toxic elements. So any exposure while opening may cause certain diseases. So don't try to open it. Don't try to figure it out that how do we recycle at home. Do not sell it to a kabadiwala, because the kabadiwala, as I said, may burn wires. He may use unscientific methods for disposal. So avoid giving your electronic waste to kabadiwalas. If you have to give your electronic waste, either give it to, as I said, the collection points, or you can hand it over to the recyclers. So these are the only two channels that one should utilize. One should not give it to a scrap dealer or a unauthorized kabadiwala who is coming at home. And one of the important things that I would also like to say is, do not keep on storing electronics at home that at some point in time we will recycle. If you have something, pass it away for recycling, because what it does is it will stop some amount of mining, because for the same materials now we don't need to mine products. So now we don't need to mine materials. So okay, so these are some of the important points that I just wanted to share with you, with every one of you. And I'm happy to take questions from the class now. Yes, so Valerie, do you want to ask? Please unmute yourself. You're unable to?
I have a question about how the e-waste should be. What happens when e-waste is not recycled properly?
Okay. When e-waste is not recycled properly, it generally, so e-waste contains certain substances which are toxic. So like cyanide-based elements, there is certain amount of heavy metals, there is sometimes mercury, phosphor. So these materials will leach to the ground. They will enter your underground water. And once it happens, it starts polluting the whole ecosystem. So it is important that we avoid this thing and ensure that e-waste is responsibly recycled. In certain parts, I mean, if you may have, if you just do some search, you will find piles and piles of e-waste lying in certain countries, dumped in open yards, dumped in rivers, and all that is causing huge toxicity in the whole ecosystem. Yes, Soham, please. Soham, please ask your question. We can't hear you, Soham, just a second.
Yes, sir. My question is that when we give our e-waste to a responsible source, then how do they recycle the waste?
Okay. So again, today we don't have enough time to go through this. But if you now, the good thing is you are on a journey to discover. So under this journey, look for responsible recycling. There are a lot of videos of recycling companies who will show you how to recycle responsibly. So what happens when once this product is given to a responsible recycler, this is, they open the product and they segregate the product into different metals. So iron, copper, tin, you know, all the materials are segregated. The components are then treated in different conditions using specified chemicals, and all the material is extracted back for reuse. So for example, you know, in e-waste, you have so many materials. If you are able to pull that material out of recycling, you will not need to mine those materials. But this needs to be done in a scientific way. So if you do a search, and I would encourage all of you, there are a whole range of recycling plants across the world. Search for e-waste recycling and you will get a lot of videos where you can understand how it is recycled responsibly. Ranjana, are you trying to talk? We can't hear you. Let me try to unmute. You're muted right now. Okay, Ishan, you seem to have one more question. Please ask. Yeah, Ishan, please ask. Yeah, it's difficult to unmute. I can't find an unmuting option now. Please feel free to type questions if you are unable to talk. I will read it from the chat and I will try to answer. Okay, someone has asked, what is the meaning of collection points? So collection points are physical spaces, like you go to a shop for buying products. Collection points are places where you can go to give away your old products for recycling purposes. So Karosambhav, our organization, for example, has 50 collection points across the country. There are other organizations who also have collection point. If you are all at any point in time, you are unable to find collection point, go to the website of the brand who has sold the products and you would most likely find this information. It is their duty to provide solutions for recycling to all of us as citizens. Okay, there is another question. If we humans do not recycle anything, what change will be seen? So we will first of all start out of materials. Electronics, for example, requires a lot of rare earth materials. And today, if we look at how much rare earths are available, we have only reserves for the next 30 years. So after 30 years, we will not have a mobile phone, we will not have a laptop because there is no more material left to produce them. On the other hand, we would have created so much toxicity in our own environment that we will all be facing ill impacts because of improper recycling of waste. So what can we do for this? The first thing is, whenever you are buying or anyone in your home is buying any product, ask, do we really need that product? Sometimes we just buy a product for no reason. Your parents may have a working mobile phone, you may have a working laptop, but you still want another laptop. You know, you may be asking for a smartwatch, you may be asking for a tablet. Why do we need so many things? If we have a working product, first of all, we should be satisfied with what we have. Only if we really need a new product, we should go for it. That's the first thing I think we all should do. So buy only what you need, because if you can decrease the amount of products we buy, we can reduce the burden on environment. Second thing, once you have bought, take care of the product. Don't use it, don't misuse it, don't treat it badly so that it has a much longer lifespan. The third part, once it becomes dead, call the brand to sell you the product, look out for the solutions for recycling it, hand it over, or go to the collection point that they have said, drop your e-waste for recycling there. If you do not find, there will be scenarios where you will find no collection point in your city. So then go to, you know, then as students start protesting, you know, file your protests on multiple platforms like change.org. You know, if you want to write public interest litigations, your teachers can help you in writing. You know, there are today platforms like change.org where you can go and write public petitions that these companies are not providing me any solution. So raise your voice. Let people know that we are looking for answers and the companies are not providing. So be an active citizen and participate and drive the change. So this is what my suggestion would be if you are to solve this problem.
So we plan to have a petition signed, online petition signed as one of the weekly activity by the students so that they are exposed to raising the voice and how can we do it. We plan to do it. So most of the children, I believe, are unable to mute because all of us were unmuting ourselves. So I believe the back end have logged it up. But yes, children, you can write the questions, and I'm sure Pranshu sir is going to answer to all of them. And thank you, Pranshu, very much. This is the first meeting, so you know the online etiquettes we are missing somewhere. Maybe
it's okay, madam. This is the regular live. You know, we are talking to students, so I'm so used to this. So the beautiful fact is everyone is asking questions. They are participating, and that's the beauty of this seminar. It's not about etiquettes or not. The fact that we are all participating, are committed to the cause, is the best thing.
Okay. So, Charu, if we can unmute everybody and children, now we have to really follow the etiquettes. If all of you unmuted, then if somebody is speaking, the others have to be quiet and wait for your turn. Okay. That's what we do when the class is going and we have put some points. These are the online etiquettes. So, I'm sure Charu, ma'am, she's going to unmute all of you and then you can ask some more questions. And I am so happy to see Nigat, Seema, and I can see Ranjana also wanted to ask so many questions. Liaquat, I'm happy to see you. So many of you are there. Children are raising their hands. Charu, if you can look into it, please, now. She will be, don't worry, the host is looking into it and she is going to unmute all of you. In the meantime, you can still write down. Ranju, if you've seen some chat,
yes, I am
you can answer at the time.
So there are questions, what can we do to prevent the diseases caused by e-waste? Well, the only thing is to take precautions. Once the diseases happen, it is very difficult to solve things. So as I said, only buy things when you use, need them, take care of them so that they have a longer life. Once they are dead, send them for recycling. If you're not finding recycling solutions, raise your voice. As a citizen of India, as a citizen of many parts, many countries today, there are laws which mandate brands to give you recycling solutions. So if they are not giving those solutions to you, raise your voice. Let them know that we need these solutions.
So I believe all of you, and we call out the names. We call out the names, all right? So we have Jyoti Kumar first, and then we'll call out the names and we keep on questioning. I can see the hands now. Jyoti Kumar, please ask. Unmute yourself, you'll be able to do so now. So not there. Then I have this expert. The name is expert. You raised your hand just now. Please ask, son. Yes, expert. Yeah.
Yes, mom. Mom, I want to ask, the company responsibility is to dispose the e-waste, but how we will know that the e-waste is properly disposed or not?
Very good question. I love that. Million. And this is the attitude that we all should carry. Always question, ask, you know, seek answers. So what you should do is, if you are giving away your electronic waste to someone, always ask, what are you going to do with it? Do some research and understand, is it the right thing? I mean, I can do a whole program for you, but today we don't have enough time to go into details of this. But you have the full right to ask anyone to whom you are giving your waste on what are you going to do with it, how do you recycle, and you will be amazed by the information you will gather.
That's what it is all about. So Ishani now. Ishani, yes, please.
Yes, sir. I'm Ishan.
Yes, Ishan.
Sir,
please go ahead.
Sir, as we said that as we will burn coppers and these things till 5-6 years more, what it will fertilize or everything, it would burn, and it would make things bad, everything as we discussed. But if we will not recycle these products or not manufacture, so what will happen after 5-6 years?
If we don't recycle, the first thing that will happen is we will run out of materials to make new products. So when you grow up, you will not have a mobile phone, you will not have a car, you will not have. So be ready for that word. So if you want to have anything, we need to start recycling now. Otherwise, we will run out of materials to create new products. So it is important message for all our parents that start recycling, because I may need a car, you know, when I grow up. So,
sir, what are the points that we can do to spread awareness about this e-waste?
You can, so, okay, multiple things. First of all, start from your home. Tell your parents what you have learned from here today. What is electronic waste? How should it be recycled? The fact that they should not give or sell their e-waste to a kabadiwala. Stop that from happening. Then tell them, if they are working in their, you know, so your father would be working somewhere, your mother would be working somewhere. So tell them in their office, they should spread the message. Then go to your neighbors, go to your family members, tell them about this message. If you ever go and buy a product, look if that company is also creating recycling solutions. Because any company which is selling the product should also be willing to take it back. If they are not doing it, write a letter to them that they should start this as a practice. Because only when we start, all of us start doing these things, change will come.
Yes, sir. Thank
so
you.
Now we have Anvisha. Anvisha, please go ahead and ask.
Yes, ma'am. So I wanted to ask that how do the companies recycle the collected e-waste?
So what happens in e-waste recycling is generally three type of processes. The first process is of segregation. So if you think of a mobile phone, it has a lot of components. So first of all, you start unscrewing and separating all the materials that you can do manually. So you will have some plastics, you will have a glass, you will have a printed circuit board. Now these different materials are sent for very detailed recycling. So plastics would be sent for plastics recycling, which may be a chemical process. Your liquid crystal display. So all these materials, they have different recycling technologies by which they are recycled. They are detailed. It's like, it's similar technologies that one deploys while creating a product. So similarly, you have to deploy different technologies for recycling them so that you can take out different metals and non-metals out of these products, which can again be reused.
Okay, sir.
Shani Ghosh is there. Thank you, Pranshu, for all your answers. Yes, I can see the digital hand. I'm on the basis of that, I'm asking. So, Valerie, you want to ask another question? See, we have got 10 minutes to go before we say we call it a day. Yes, go ahead, Valerie.
Okay, ma'am. When we discuss that the chemicals in e-waste can cause harm to human, is there any other way we can recycle it apart from human labor?
So there are scientific methods, there are technologies to recycle. The problem is not that there are not enough technologies. The problem is we as people are not giving it to the right place. We are just disposing it off, we are sending it off to someone who doesn't know how to recycle. So if we start changing that patterns, which means we are only going to give our waste to people who can recycle, we will start seeing a big change.
Thank you, Pranshu. Thank you, Valerie. Shivansh, please. You raised your hand. Digital hand, I see. Shivansh, I see your hand. Would you like to ask? Yeah, you switched on your video. Yes, go ahead, please.
Sir, ma'am, I want to ask.
Okay, you ask because Shiv has to unmute. All right. Please ask.
Ma'am, I want to ask that if where is the right place to dispose the e-waste?
Yeah, so as I said, you can use collection centers of Karosambo. Someone was asking, do we have a solution in Assam? We do have a collection center in Guwahati. You can visit them. There is also, you can, if you go to on our website, you can also request, put a request for pickup from your homes. So if there is a minimum quantity of waste, we can also do that. But I mean, Karosambab is only one of the organizations providing solutions. You can always reach out to the brand. So if you are using a Lenovo mobile laptop, you can call to Lenovo. If you are using a Dell laptop, you can call Dell. You can go there to their website and you will find where they have put on their own collection points.
Thank you, Pranshu. Aditi, yes, go ahead, please.
Sir, I have a question. Sir, we are too small to give e-waste to the industries. So what we can do the e-waste?
Okay. So first of all, no one is small. You know, our spirits should be large, size does not matter. Really. So if we are all spirited, we can encourage our parents to work in us, who can work in a community. If you all children in a community work together, start collecting waste in the community, then one of your parents can make a call to either Karosambhav or any other organization which can pick up this waste or to the brand, and they will come and pick up. So don't think that you are small. If you all put in your right efforts, you will bring that change.
Thank you, Pranshu. Now, my dear boys and girls, we plan to collect this e-waste, put it in our houses, and from 15 January to 31st of January, we'll be requesting collection centers to collect it. We have to keep a record. We have to weigh this and who has deposited. And then we have to come in Guinness Book of World Record. That is the type of e-waste you're going to collect, that amount. So not little. That is part of this project. And as we travel ahead, we'll be letting you know. And then Pranshu says, always there to help us. We can always submit in his list. But it will be a collective, the school, your teacher, your change agent, your mentor is going to guide you how we are going to dispose of this e-waste. In the meantime, keep your eyes open to collect at your own places. In case you're not going to the school, or to the school, we can have a designated place. We'll be sharing details. So there are quite a number of hand raised here. After Aditi, we have Shubhangi. Yes, Shubhangi. Ishan has already got two chances. We go for Shubhangi now.
Sir, after the e-waste is recycled, what happens to that?
After the e-waste is recycled, what we get is different sort of metals like tin, copper, iron, aluminium. All these metals are coming out of e-waste, glass, so metals and non-metals. Now, these materials can be used for creating new products. So we don't need to do fresh mining to get metals now. With the existing waste, we have taken out metals and non-metals, and they can be reused back to create new products. So in effect, what have you avoided? You have avoided mining of new materials. Now, all of you know mining causes a lot of pollution. You have to cut down trees, you have to dig earth, which again then leads to a lot of chemical utilization and a whole range of pollution. So you, by recycling, you have avoided all that things from happening.
Thank you, Pranshu. We have Sinchan.
Thank you, ma'am. Sir, I have a question that when e-waste burst or explodes, does it gives out hazardous particles or waves?
We can't hear you. You have to be louder, son. Sinchan, you have to be louder.
Madam, do you know I got it? So, yeah. So what he's asking is, if we, you know, are there hazardous particles generated when we recycle? So this happens when we don't recycle it in the right way. So if you give it to a kabadi wala and he handles it and he starts recycling it, because he is doing it in a environment which is not proper, which is not scientific, it can cause a lot of toxins to leach out. And by doing proper recycling, we can avoid this to happen.
Thank you, Bhavya. Yes, we can see your hand there, the physical hand. Please speak.
Sir, some electric waste I am asking one question, sir. How the electric car wasting, sir?
Please repeat, Bhavya.
How the electronic are wasting, sir?
What is the question, Bhavya? I still did not get it.
Sir, how the electronic are wasting, sir?
Linda, madam, did you get it?
How electronics are wasting? Bhavya, why don't you write down this question in the chat window? You're fabulous. We'll read it, okay? We somehow cannot follow. In the meantime, we'll ask the next person. So after that, we have...
Ma'am, I have sent in chat also. That's why only I asked the...
Again ask.
The mic also.
Okay, again ask, Bhavya. Please ask again.
How the electronic are wasting?
How the electronics are... What is the last word?
Wasting. Yes.
Okay, so are you asking how, why do they become dead or why do they die?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So any product is, you know, so if you remember physics, you know, one of the biggest phenomena is, well, you are very young right now for physics, but the way the world works is we always move from an organized system to a disorganized system. That's the natural tendency of universe. So it moves from, it's called entropy. So from systems which are highly organized, we always move towards, so it's a natural tendency of things. So you will never see a thing, you know, a broken thing getting repaired on its own. Or, you know, a broken bulb getting fixed on its own. You will always see a working thing breaking down because that's the natural tendency because of the law of entropy. So any product that has been created, it will eventually decay. It will, because of different ways of utilization, friction, utilization of elements that are in that product, it will start moving from an organized system to a disorganized system. So this is the natural order of things, that they will go from being organized to disorganized.
Thank you, Pranshu. We have Chandan. Yes, Chandan. Yes, Chandan, we have got just 2 minutes left now. You know, ours is sharp 1 hour. So let's be quick. Quick question. Yes, Chandan. Chandan, please ask, Bete. Unmute yourself. You had unmuted. Again, you're muted now. What time we have was not asked. It's Guru Balji. Who's Guru Balji? Please ask.
Ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes. Go ahead. We could hear you, please.
Is there any possibility of biodegradable electronic items?
Yes.
It's a very interesting question. The answer is always yes. We can always come up with nice technologies. Do we have it yet? The answer is no. So for certain things, we do have biodegradable materials, but not for everything. So we still have not seen electronics which will biodegrade, but do we expect them to come at some point in time? The answer is a big yes. A lot of people are doing research on this idea that after the utilization, the products should ideally biodegrade on their own. But as of now, we don't have them. I would encourage you to become scientists to solve this problem.
Sir, Ishan.
Ishan, this is the fourth question. Let's give everybody a chance. Yours would be the last one. Okay, you'll have your chance. Let's have Ishan coming. You would definitely get another chance, Ishan.
Okay.
Ikishore.
It is, sir, it is good for nature or not? E-wasting.
E-wasting is not good for nature. So if we do not recycle electronic waste, it will harm nature. It will lead to a lot of toxins going into air, water, soil, and which will ultimately impact us as well as any other species who are living in that environment.
Shashwat,
yes, sir.
There, please. Ishani Ghosha, Ghosh or Ghoshal, Ghosh. Anybody there? Shiv Vanshika, would you like to ask?
Yes, ma'am.
Please,
ma'am, where is the right way to dispose the e-waste?
Sir.
And ma'am, from where we will collect it?
So you will collect e-waste. You can collect e-waste from your homes. You can collect e-waste from your neighbors, from there, from your, you can go to your neighbor's houses, to your colonies. That's the way to collect e-waste. Now, where will it go? Once you have collected enough e-waste, you can either bring it to your school. So, you know, the waste can be collected at a school level, and then we can come and pick it up from the school for recycling, or we will find new solutions. The thing is, you focus on connection, we will come and bring solutions to you.
And sir, where is the right place to dispose it?
Where is the
right place to dispose the e-waste?
I just want to check. Where is the right place to dispose the e-waste? So, right place is to go to the centers set up by recyclers or the brands for recycling. So, as I said earlier,
yes, you
find these places on the websites of companies.
Ishan, yours is the last question now. Go ahead, please.
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Thank you for giving me a chance. Okay, so sir, that every electronic device has a time limit, and when its time limit is dead, so what, where it, how is it the right way to dispose it off or to destroy it off without burning and environmental safe.
Okay. So you are asking, once a product is dead, how do we dispose it off? So as I said, there are simple ways. You can, if you have a, like if you think of a mobile phone, it has brand written on top of it. You know, is it an Apple phone? Is it a Samsung phone? So you can go to the website of these companies and they will tell you where you can go and dispose it off. So you can either follow that channel. Sometimes there will be a mobile number written that you can call this mobile and the company will arrange for a pickup. So you can also call them to come and pick it up. So there are multiple channels. Collection centers, collection points, which have been created by companies. So you can go there and dispose it off.
And sir, my father's mobile, he has repaired, tried to repair it two times by the company recycle, but it didn't work. So he need to dispose it off only.
Yeah, now he needs to dispose it off. So as I said, he can either reach out to Karusamba, or you can all collect it together and then we will arrange a pickup somewhere from your school.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir, for answering my query.
Sir, Kiranjot, yours is the last one, but we call it a day now. A long time. Kiranjot, I see your hand now. Would you like to ask?
Oh, what will happen when I put the things that are not recycled in my recycle bin?
Okay. So, first of all, such products should not be coming in the market. If you are finding any products that cannot be recycled, it is important to raise noise around this. So write a petition to people who can stop such products from coming in the market. You may write a petition to our dear Prime Minister, you can write it to President of India, but raise the voice. Don't let such products go unnoticed. So if you are coming across products which are not, which cannot be recycled, let government know that they should ban these products.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. Chandan, you raised your hand again. Unmute yourself and speak better. You could not speak earlier. Yours is the last question.
Sir, what are the chemicals which are in the e-waste? And what are the harms of the chemicals?
So, I mean, there is an endless list of chemicals which go in electronics. So many of them are very harmful. So as I had shared in some of my slides earlier, these chemicals could include, for example, brominated flame retardants, certain kind of additives, and all these elements lead to very, very significant human impact on human health. So, for example, they could cause lung cancer, kidney failure, brain damage, asthma, bronchitis. So, e-waste has a whole range of different type of compounds which can cause toxicity in the environment.
Thank you. Aman, you still want to ask?
Yes, please? I can.
Yes, ma'am.
My question is,
is there any harmful effect to animals of the e-waste?
Yes. Animals like us, animals also go through similar challenges. They also face a whole range of diseases which are caused by pollutants which are present in electronic waste. So yes, the answer is they also get severely impacted.
Oh, thank you, Pranshu. This is, you know, we just started.
Ma'am, please, can I tell something?
Okay, son. Dear, please go ahead. Who's there? Okay. Samprit Mukherjee. Yes, please.
Yes.
Please go ahead.
Hello.
So children, what we do, we would definitely invite Pranshu sir for the second time.
Hello.
Let us walk through this journey of e-waste, rise up for e-waste, and have n number of questions. Many more. As
ma'am,
you go,
ma'am,
the answers correct. Will be known to you. We'll ask sir to come back to us in the month of January. New
no,
year,
ma'am,
new questions
is...
and new answers. Yes, who's there now?
Yeah, Amritli, please ask.
Good evening. Sir? Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, sir. Ma'am, my question is that which is the right way to recycle the e-waste?
Amritli, we have already answered this, you know, many times. So I would just request all of you to pay attention now. Dilo madam, we can't hear you. We have somehow lost your voice.
Sir, I can't ask. Can I ask you?
Sir, I have one question.
Can I ask you? Hello, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
So we will close the call today as requested
Hello.
By madam. We have already exceeded the time.
Sir,
by,
I want to tell something, sir. Last, please, sir.
We will meet again in January, and thank you for a good day. And I really look forward
Excuse
to
me, supporting sir.
You.
Thank you, sir, for explaining us about e-waste. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, children. Have a great
Thank day. You, sir. Thank you very much. It is a very good. Thank you. Sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for
thank you.
Teaching
us the email. Thank you.
Sir.
Thank you, ma'am. It is very good. Thank you, sir.